If you watch that bobber there, I'm going to talk through it. There's a lot of things that happens when you're fishing this bait. The biggest thing right now is the bait. You can see all of the chartreuse, so I know that that bait is suspended in the water column. So I know it's sitting there 7.5 feet under the water. It could be 50 foot underneath that, but at least to that point, I know exactly it's at 7.5 feet. The beauty of this bait during the times of the year, most people, you know, back in the 90s, the Nickel Brothers came out and they started making this technique a little bit more popular. It's basically a wintertime bite, you know, after water temperature drops below 50 degrees, you know, that it takes off. I've been doing this year round my entire life. I've caught more big fish with this stupid little thing than most people can comprehend. And I've won a lot of money with it too. The neat thing is when you throw it out and you see that bobber hit, watch the bobber come back. That jig is gonna take its time really slow to go straight down, straight down, straight down, and then it's finally straight underneath the bobber. It took a good 4 to 5 seconds for that bobber to let that pendulum underneath it. If you did the same cast and you wanted a quicker drop, you bring it out there, you drop your line and watch the bobber float backwards into it. So now it's half the time. Now the beauty of this, depending on the depth of that lead, if I use a 7 foot, 12 foot, you name it, if I have a 12 foot lead, I throw it out there and I let the line slack and that bobber drifts back towards the jig and it takes 6 seconds to sit upright. Okay, I know what's going on. If I do the same cast and I let my line go and it goes down and that bobber stops at 2 seconds, a fish ate the bait on the drop. I could actually, it's basically a strike indicator. I could follow that bobber and actually know where I'm getting hit. If I'm getting hit 3 foot underwater, 4 foot underwater, I could adjust the bobber right then to the specific depth that those fish are eating at. The key thing with this bobber. So if you throw it up on the bank and that bobber doesn't turn over real quick, it's sitting on the structure. It's sitting down on the bank, you know, the ground somewhere. So what you do is you pop it real slow. Now, depending on the depth, this is precision depth. I've been in days where pre-fishing, these fish will come up and stage at 5 foot, stage at 7 foot, stage at 12 foot exactly. I can work my jig across the bottom and right when it hits 7, 10, 12 foot of water, the bobber will turn around and sit straight up and I'll let it sit there, dead stick, pre-spawn. The cool thing about it, as that bait sits there suspended, if a fish comes up and eats it and lifts up that much, the bobber will turn sideways. So you can actually tell when you get a bite, even when it's only 1 inch off the ground, because when a fish eats it, it'll actually relax the weight of that bait and it'll set the hook, and I've caught 5 to 10 pounders doing that too. So this is precision technique that is just absolutely money, and that's for basic depth control. If you have fish in 30 foot of water, slip through bobber, or you do what we call the do nothing. You can throw this jig out there in 30, 40, 50, 60 foot of water and still catch quality fish. And like I said, we're gonna see if we can catch a fish out of here on the float and fly with the bobber technique. We might go out in 60 foot of water today. I'll throw the same bait out there with the same system and catch fish out of 60 foot of water. So you really gotta look at this bait closely, because there's a lot of magic put into this thing. This is one of my favorite baits to throw. People think I'm the big bait guy. I've caught more fish on a float and fly my entire life than I've ever had with the swim bait. I just don't show a lot of people how I do it. Shad, so, oh, dude, right there. Did you see that bobber go down? Let's see what, right there, I turn around and see, oh, dude. Is that a big smallie? What is that?